up anyway. We're ready to do this. What's up, everybody? So I've been hearing from a lot of you lately that your schedule is pretty wild while you're in that after your degree, before getting licensed, accruing hours for licensure phase. Hearing from you all made me reflect a little bit about what it was like when I was in that phase of life, and it was pretty out of control. My schedule was all over the place. So I thought it might be kind of an interesting experiment to pull up my calendar from back in my pre-licensure days, see what kinds of things I was up to, and kind of show you what it looked like. Here we go. Don't mind my dog while she joins us in the background for however long of this video she decides. So to give you a little backstory of where I was at when I was postdoc and pre-licensure days, I did pursue a doctorate degree in grad school. I have a PsyD and I graduated in 2012. Now, my husband also was completing a doctorate at the same time, we graduated at the same time, and we both had postdoc training to do before getting licensed. And his postdoc work took us from San Diego to the San Francisco Bay Area, where neither of us had any connections. And just to fill in a little more detail about that picture, we moved to the city of Palo Alto, which FYI is the 7th most expensive zip code in all of the United States. When we first got here, I was completely unemployed and I had no path for accruing hours towards licensure. So it was in this context in fall of 2012 that I needed to start accruing hours for licensure. And at first I landed a gig in San Francisco at a group private practice. The downside of that place was I needed to do pretty much all of my own marketing and I had no idea what I was doing. So for the first 3 months of that job, I had zero clients. So by early 2013, it was very clear to me that I needed additional work if there was any chance I was gonna accrue my hours for licensure in a reasonable period of time. So I started looking for another therapy-related job. But in the meantime, because it was hard to find anything at the time, I also took a job at my church, which was unrelated to the field of therapy, just for the sake of paying the bills. And then by spring of 2013, I finally landed another job at another therapy group practice. And of course, by the time I'd landed that second private practice job, my first private practice job was just starting to take off. And sure enough, it was only about a year after landing that second therapy job that I then had enough hours for licensure, and I got licensed in November of 2014. Now, my memory from that year of life feels really chaotic. I mentioned that the first group practice I worked in was in San Francisco while we lived in Palo Alto. The second group practice that I got a job at was in San Leandro, and my church was located in San Jose. So I have my laptop here and I thought it would be really interesting to take you into my calendar from 2014, right in the thick of everything, right before I got licensed. Just giving a cursory pass over it right now, I feel really anxious and overwhelmed looking at what I was up to, let alone knowing how much driving was happening in between. Just so you're following along, anything that says river is referring to work I was doing at church. And if there's anything that's blurred out on your screen like this, it means that it was something related to personal friend or something like that, and I don't want to just display their information for the world to see. Oh yeah, and let's not forget that in the midst of this, I was also leading a small group at my church, which entailed a fair amount of work at the time. I'm curious to just kind of go through a couple of weeks to see what they look like in this month of April. Let's see. Oh gosh, this one's worse. Wow. I'll just go through each item that's happening here and take you along for the ride. So here on Sunday, church, that means work. It says 8:30 to 11:30, but I usually showed up around 6:30 for work, and then choir was choir practice after church, so that was a pretty solid 8-hour day from like 6:30 till 2. Everything on this calendar that has the white background like this is referring to clients that I was seeing in the San Leandro practice, and anything else that says client that has the pinkish background is referring to clients I was seeing in San Francisco. So as we move into Monday, you can see I needed to be in San Leandro by 7 a.m. and I remember that drive very well. It took me usually an hour to an hour and a half to get to work. I went straight from there to a friend's house to help them move that day, and then while I was there, I also snuck aside for a couple of hours to get some emails done for work. On Tuesday mornings, I headed to San Francisco to get both individual and group supervision because I was an intern, and then I drove straight to church for staff meeting. So mind you, that is a 55-mile drive up from San Francisco to staff meeting. And then after staff meeting, I started preparing for an anxiety seminar that I was apparently also leading at church. After that, then I would drive back home from San Jose to Palo Alto. Moving on to Wednesday, you can see that I had a few clients scheduled in San Leandro, so I probably left at like 6 a.m. to make it for my first client. And then I had supervision with my San Leandro supervisor. Now, fortunately, Thursday this week, it looked like I had it pretty much open, except I needed to go to church to do work there in the evenings. And then on Friday, it was off to see just a few clients in San Francisco because I still really hadn't figured out the private practice thing by this point. And Good Friday means that I needed to go back to church to work the Good Friday service at church as well. And yes, I worked on Saturdays, so I had three clients back to back again in San Francisco. And then I came back to make it to a friend's birthday by the afternoon. I mean, all in all, maybe this looks pretty doable, but the amount that I was sitting in my car just, it was a lot. The next week, what do we have? My goodness. Oh yeah, look at that. I got to church at 5:30. Because, you know, there's not enough hours in the day. This week looks slightly more manageable. Let's see the following week. Man, I forgot that I would go to San Leandro to see clients at 7 a.m. That just sounds terrible. I probably left the house by 5:30 at the latest to see a 7 a.m. client. And then to see an intake and then a bunch of clients back to back, followed by supervision. And yes, I had to lead small group in San Jose straight after that. So basically this entire block was me sitting in traffic. Okay, good for me. I managed to go boogie boarding on Thursday with some friends. Looks like I got to have that Thursday off. That's wonderful. Oh gosh, this is, I don't even like looking at this. Okay, work at church, more work at church. Oh, yep, this was a work at church thing again. Saw a 7 a.m. client in San Leandro, made it back to San Jose again to work at church. Here's Tuesday, made it to San Francisco, but I had to scooch over to church to make it for a staff meeting. Here's a church-related meeting. Then I had to scooch over to San Leandro by 8 a.m., even though I had a two-hour gap before my next client, because I needed to meet with my supervisor. And then I had to prepare for a small group at church. I had some personal things going on that were actually quite intense on Thursday, and then I had to make it back to church for work. Somewhere around here is when things really started taking off pretty nicely for me as far as my San Francisco practice went. I mean, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I had 6 clients plus supervision all in San Francisco. I mean, that's a beautiful schedule. And then of course I came back to San Francisco again for more clients. I think somewhere in here I took a vacation. Please tell me. Yes, eventually there was a vacation. So here's the end of my vacation and right back into seeing all my clients again. As I'm looking at this schedule, I'm feeling two things. One, I can't believe just how wild this schedule is. If I were doing this schedule today, I would burn out hard. And the second thing that I'm thinking is I know there are so many of you who are working a schedule like this, barely taking home enough to pay the bills. So my heart goes out to you all if you're in that space. I remember feeling like I just needed to hit the ground running, get those hours done ASAP so that I could sooner bring home a much more reasonable paycheck in order to afford living in this area. Reflecting on the question of what I might have done differently if I could go back and do it all over again, I mean, on the one hand, I'd like to say that I wish I took things more slowly, but that's based on the information that I have today, knowing that things worked out in the end. But at the time, you just don't know how things are gonna go. And so I think knowing what I knew then, I'm not really sure I would have done it differently. What I do know is I did absolutely burn out in the midst of it, and I needed to quit a couple of those jobs as soon as I could afford it. Well, I hope you found this video helpful wherever you may be in your journey towards licensure. And until next time, from one therapist to another, I wish you well. Today's video is brought to you by TherapyNotes.com. Therapy Notes helps with scheduling, notes, and billing so that you can spend more time with your clients and less time on back office paperwork. Click the link in the description of this video to get 2 months to try it for free with no commitment. Sophie, come here. See her over there? She wants to be a movie star, she said. That was hotter than I thought it was gonna be. What you doing? Listen. What? My husband is home very early. Hello.